Apocalypse survivor Joel Dylan O'Brien is shown with his new friend boy, Hero, an Australian Kelpie, in Love and Monsters. Michael Matthews' Love and Monsters is a post-apocalyptic quest comedy set 7 years after a giant meteor nearly crashes into the Earth. Nearly, because, just as in Armageddon, or Deep Impact, the plucky humans are able to put aside their differences and blow the threat out of the sky. Yay, indomitable human spirit. Except here, the heartstring-plucking triumphalism that usually accompanies this sort of international cooperation is undercut by some intended consequences. All the rockets the Earth fired at the meteor have chemicals onboard, propellants, accelerants, oxidizing agents, probably some hydrazine, as well as various payloads that go boom, some of which no doubt contain radioactive material. And after they explode the giant meteor, all this debris floats back down to Earth, dusting the planet with science gunk, causing fauna to mutate and produce monstrously large frogs, ants, snails, beetles, etc., that immediately become apex predators and commence decimating the human population. Snarf, snarf. So the humans make a run for it, and the ones that do not get snacked upon eventually head underground, where they build some funky Fallout shelter-style bunkers and set about the important work of trying to repopulate the world. Some of them still have to go to the surface occasionally, to rummage through devastated grocery stores for old canned goods past their expiration date, but in the post-apocalypse, one is not so picky. And in the process, some of them become protein sources for the recently rapidly evolved. Sad, but maybe not so sad as our hero's circumstances. Joel Dawson Dylan O'Brien is a 17-year-old who is just about to level up with his high school girlfriend Aimee, Jessica Henwick, when all the really bad stuff starts. They are torn apart just as the world was about to end. Now, 7 years later, Joel is the mascot of a small colony, the affable beta male who cooks the minestrone and fiddles with the radio while the tougher guys and gals attend to the adulting, which includes the occasional fighting off of overgrown insects. Joel has a tendency to freeze up in stressful situations, but he has shown he can learn. His drawings have gotten much better than they were back when he was making out with Aimee in the back of her Jeep Wrangler before things fell apart. He's become a naturalist, sketching the creatures and noting the various ways in which they might be taken out. Shotgun to the face, good to know. But Joel has also, via his adventures with ham radio, recently located Aimee. She's in a colony on the coast of what used to be California, about 85 miles away from his colony, where he's increasingly feeling like a third wheel. So he decides to set out on a dangerous journey to rejoin her. Good luck.